Next week, Kansas City, Missouri voters are going to be asked to raise their sales tax and try to keep their water and sewer bills down. Those are the two questions on the city ballot. In Commitment 2012 coverage, Micheal Mahoney looks at both of them. Micheal?
Glenn, questions one and two on the Kansas City ballot deal with a variety of things, including the city's parks, sales taxes, the city's roads, and your water and your sewer bill. The kids at this community center and other folks who use the city's parks and taxpayers as well all have a stake in question one. It eliminates the city's vehicle tax, which is paid at the point of a sale, and three other current taxes. It also takes the parks department off the city's general fund budget. Part of the sales tax hike would be used to give the parks a dedicated source of money.
This is not a windfall of cash by any means. We'll net about another $3 million.
And they hope put the parks on a reliable financial footing. They also think using the sales tax will spread this burden, since about a third of the sales tax is paid by suburbanites. Question one would also take the budget money parks gets now and set it aside for improving Kansas City streets. $15 million a year, or about seven times more than they're spending on them this year.
What this would do for the first time, it would provide a stable level of funding for this, for road resurfacing.
Question number two deals with the city's water supply, specifically the massive repair bill that the city faces for its out-of-date sewer system, $2.5 billion. Question two would let the city water department issue $500 million in bonds to help pay for that huge project. Without it, they claim, water and sewer rates, which are already surging, could double. This, they claim, could keep them down a bit.
Closer to the 13% range is what we're hoping for over the next five or six years. And after that, we expect those rates to actually reduce down to inflationary type rate increases.
Now, the most serious opposition that this act should face may be from the Kansas City Star editorial board. They're editorializing against it, and that should be a source of opposition down the stretch. That's the latest from here. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Micheal. Kansas City questions one and two will be on next Tuesday's ballot throughout the city.